you have a chance to be in Rome to study. But this is not just for your personal growth, but it's like the parable of the talents. You have been given a chance, and it depends on you if you make this gift produce more gift for the others, or if you just take that for you, keep for your life without any other fruits. So any gift of God is also a big responsibility. And also given more when we ask more. And so I wish you that you're coming back to the Philippines will help the church there also to grow with your talents, with your studies, with your view of a different experience. Take the best you have found here, not the worst. Try to discern and bring back to the people there what is most needed. And also, you have found that there are different societies here in the Western countries, so called advanced. There are some problems in getting in relation with spiritual values and with God. But there is very simple, very natural to be in relation with God. On the other hand, it could be also more a way of doing things than something which is a personal choice. Yet, if you want to be a Christian, you have to fight against an environment which is not helping, mostly. There, the environment is very helping, but also you are not demanded to be really committed, because you follow the mainstream. So you have to take the best from here, the personal choice, and also when you go there to live as a community, but also to stress the importance of personal decisions and formations, and giving also all the insights and the beauty that you have discovered in your studies. And first of all, since you have titles, and they will call you not masters, but professors. And don't forget that you are at the service of the people, and not the other way around. In the Philippines, now is the year of the clergy and consecrated persons, and the image that they have chosen is the Lord washing the feet. So, if I, the master, have done that, you have also to wash the feet of each other. So, don't go back with this kind of mentality that you are above the other, more important, because you know more, you have more experience, you have traveled, you have seen the world. Go back saying what I've been given is to serve these people who don't have money, who don't have possibilities, and maybe they don't have all the opportunity I had. We are at the service of the people, not people serving us, because we have some titles. This is very, very important. And that makes the difference between good servants and leaders and not so good servants and leaders. Take advantage of the other who haven't finished yet. Don't waste time, because time is very precious and important. And you have an opportunity to study, which is not any longer after. So make the maximum of this opportunity. And let us ask the Holy Spirit, and today is Pentecost, to rekindle the gift we have received at the ordination, and to find the joy of being part of the people, leader, but servant, as our Lord has done. With this, I will give you my blessing, and also, as the Pope says, I ask your prayers for the poor nuncio in the Philippines, and when you come back, if you have suggestions, advices from your, just come and tell me, and I will learn from you, all right? Let us finish with the prayer of the Lord. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
May Almighty God, through the intercession of Mary, our Mother, bless us.